Hey guys, welcome back to our Linux tutorial series presented by CryptSec. So I'm Saroj and I'll be an instructor for this video. So basically in this today video, we are going to learn some of the command line utilities for creating the partitions as well as file system in our Linux drive. Okay, so after looking some of the command line utilities, we will also look at some of the GUI interface for creating the partitions as well. So without any delay, let's get started. So I'll just open my terminal. Okay, so before creating some of the partitions, we need to check some of the drives available for our system. So to do so, we need to type sudo fdisk as l. So I need to give the sudo password. Okay, so as you can see in my screen, there are different drives installed in my system. Okay, there are dev, sta, stb and stc. So my main boot drive is dev sta. Okay, so as you can see in my screen that there is also dev stc, which is my USB drive. Okay, so for this example, I am creating some of the partitions for in this drive. Okay, so to do so, we need to type sudo cfdisk, then give the drive name with it. Okay, so for this example, my drive name is dev.stc. So in Linux, every drive has its own unique name. Okay, so there are different drives name. So if I type sudo cfdisk dev stc, then as you can see in my screen, it will promote several level type. Okay, so we need to type or we need to select one of them. So for example, I will just select dots. So it will create mbr partitions. Okay, so in mbr partitions, mainly there are four free spaces. Okay, four partitions table. We can create only four partitions table in mbr. So I need to type free space, then I need to type new. Okay, then it has been asking for my partition size, so I'll just go with the default, which is 15.2 GB. Then it has asked me whether it is primary partitions or extended partitions, so I'll just go with primary. Then after we created the partitions, we need to write those partitions on my disk. Okay, so to do so, we need to type write, or we need to select write. Okay, so I'll just hit the enter. Then it has been prompting either we want to write the partition table to the disk, so I need to type yes. Okay, so after it, we need to select quit. Okay, now our partitions table is being created. So if I need to confirm it, we can type sudo fdisk l, then give the drive name with it. So my drive name is dev sdc. Okay, sorry, oh my bad. So here is fdisk. Okay, so as you can see in my screen, here is a partition name stc1. Okay, so I have created the mbr partition in my drive. So after creating the partition, we need to also give the file system with it. Okay, so to do so, we need to type sudo mkfs, which means make file system. Then we have to pass the which file system we need to create on this partition. So for this example, I will create FAT32 partition. Okay, so for that, I need to type mkfs dot vfat. Then as you can, also we can give the level, or we can give the name with it by typing dash n for name. Then I'll just back off. Okay, it's my name for this drive. Then I need to type dep sdc1. Okay, so it means I'm creating the FAT32 file system on partition sdc1. So after it, we need to press the enter. Okay, now the screen is loading. Okay, now there is no any error in my terminal. So it means I have created FAT32 file system in my drive dev sdc1, which is one of the partitions of the drive dev sdc. So it means we have successfully created partition as well as file system on our Linux system. So if I go out of this terminal, then check if there is any drive call backup or not. So as you can see in my screen, there is a backup name called drive, drive name called backup. So if I go here and hit enter, you can see in my screen it has been prompting. Okay, it has been working. So if I need to create any folder, I can create it. Say okay. So it means we have successfully created partition as well as file system on a newly drive called dev sdc. So now we have seen how we can create a partition as well as file system from the command line utilities. So let us look how we can create the same approach through the GUI interface. So for that, I'll just clear all those partitions in my drive. So it has been mounted, so I'll just unmount it. Dev sdc1. Sorry, you mount. So now it has been unmounted. So to clear all those partitions, I can type sudo wipe fs dash dash all, then pass the drive name with it. So it will clear all those partitions as well as file system from this drive. Wipe fs, this means wipe all the file system from the drive called dev sdc. So now it has cleared all those partitions as well as file system from the drive. Okay, so now we will look how we can create partitions and file system from the GUI interface. So for this example, I have used gpartite, which is present in almost all the Linux distros. So if I go to my menu and type gpartite, here you can see in my screen gpartite is here already. Hello. Okay, so I need to give the password. Now the screen is prompting the drive names installed in my system. So if I go here and select dev sdc, now as you can see in my screen, those all the partitions has been cleared out from my drive. Okay, so it has unallocated any partitions for this drive. So if I need to create this partition in my drive, then we can go to device here, and we need to create partition table. Okay, then it will ask what types of partitions we can create on this drive. So I'll just go with the default EMSTOS. Okay, and I'll just hit apply. Okay, now our partition has been created. Okay, so if you remember, after we create a partition on our drive, we need to create a file system as well. Okay, so now partition has been created. So if I go to here and clear new, then you can see it has asked the size of the partition I need to create. So I'll just go with the default, then I'll just pass here my label name, which is back off. Then we can also specify the file system we can type with it. So for this example, I'll just go with FAT32. Okay, then we can hit add. So now you can see in your screen it has created the FAT32 file system on this newly partitioned. Okay, so now we have seen how we can create the partitions from the command line as well as graphical user space. So this much for all this today video. So if you like this video, please comment down below and stay tuned for further content. Okay, so bye bye.